In this video, we're going to explore unintended RF carrier leakage coming from the IQ modulator in a vector signal generator and various methods for reducing the impact of carrier leakage on our measurement. I've already configured a 100 MHz wide 5G new radio signal on the Rodin Shorts SMW200A vector signal generator, and I'm analyzing the signal with the Rodin Shorts FSW vector signal analyzer. There's three things to note for this measurement. One, in the EVM versus carrier window, I have an EVM between 10 and 15% for the DC subcarrier, but everywhere else I have a very low EVM. Second, the constellation diagram shows a ring or bullseye pattern around each constellation point. This is indicative of a CW interferer. And third, the mean EVM in the result summary is around 0.95%. While this is still a great EVM, it could be better. So how do we reduce the impact of carrier feedthrough on our measurement? Well, if the analyzer supports it, we can ignore or compensate for the carrier leakage, which would otherwise show up as high EVM on the DC subcarrier. This is common practice. In fact, standards like LTE and Wi-Fi intentionally leave a guard band around the DC subcarrier to avoid carrier leakage from degrading the EVM. In 5G new radio, the 3GPP standards body allows for transmissions in the guard band around the DC subcarrier. This is one of many changes to increase 5GNR throughput over LTE. In the 5GNR application on the FSW, we can ignore the DC subcarrier by going to Measurement Config, Signal Description, Advanced Settings tab, and change in the handling of carrier leakage from None to Ignore DC. With the DC subcarrier ignored, the constellation diagram no longer has a ring or bullseye pattern around each constellation point, and the EVM in the result summary table improved from 0.95% to 0.80%. Now let's look at how we can improve carrier leakage at the source. Let's turn off the DC subcarrier handling on the signal analyzer. The easiest approach is to perform an on-the-fly calibration of the IQ modulator on the SMW200A. This takes less than a second to perform. Go to IQ modulator, IQ modulator, and adjust IQ modulator to current frequency. We see an immediate EVM improvement in all three displays. In the EVM versus carrier graph, the DC carrier now has less than 5% EVM. The constellation diagram no longer has a ring or bullseye pattern around each constellation point, and the EVM is improved to 0.82% EVM. While this improves the magnitude of the carrier feedthrough, it's still present. Because this is a frequency-specific on-the-fly calibration, it must be rerun every time we change the center frequency. If we want to eliminate the impact of carrier feedthrough altogether, we can apply a frequency offset to the baseband so the carrier falls out of band of the signal. A frequency offset of half the bandwidth will do, though any larger offset would work as well. On the SMW, go to Baseband, Baseband Offsets, and we'll apply a 50 MHz frequency offset to Baseband A. And if we look in the spectrum view, we can see the signal is now shifted up by 50 MHz. We need to compensate for that by shifting the entire signal back down by 50 MHz. We can see the DC carrier feedthrough is now just out of band on the lower side of the band edge because we applied a positive offset to the baseband. When we jump back to the 5GNR application, we can see that the EVM versus carrier has improved. There is no more DC leakage. There's also an improvement in the constellation diagram. And we can also see that the EVM in the result summary table has improved as well. But it may be a little difficult to remember this mental math for always having to apply a 50 MHz shift on the signal generator. So let's see if we can automate that. Go to the RF block, go to frequency, and then we can apply that 50 MHz offset here. And this is just a mathematical offset. It doesn't actually change the RF frequency. The carrier is still sitting at 27.950, but the displayed value up here says 28 gig, which is the center of the modulation band. With this, we could change the frequency around and jump up to the 39 GHz band. And while we no longer have to apply that on-the-fly calibration, it's still a good idea to do so. So we can go to IQ modulator, adjust IQ modulator to the current 39 GHz frequency. And now we're measuring this 5GNR signal at 39 gig. Thanks for watching.